What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 38 of the Ultimate Let's Play Dragon Quest VIII. Last time we found Dr. Merrick at the Ur Grotto. We found out that he is actually Marta's son, and Marta is apparently one of the heirs to the royal sages that steal away Raptor, which means she's in grave danger. We need to get to her quickly. As soon as I found my way out of this place here, even though it is just a straight line. I often joke that I get lost going in straight lines, but basically I just gotta get out of the city here. Okay, I think I'm heading in the right direction. Once I get through the inn in here, I should already be at full strength. So I'm just gonna find the door and get out of here. Here it is. Okay. Now, I'm actually not even going to warp to Marta's cottage. Reason being, it's not that far of a trek, and I'm also very close to leveling up thanks to a divination I did right after I ended the episode and right before I saved. See, I don't have that far to go. I just got to go south and a little west. Let's follow this path, and this should take us right to Marta's cottage. I should be able to get a level up by then. Let's go ahead and take these guys out. I'm not going to use Crackle on those guys, just because, ran into some issues with some of the enemies at the Herb Rattle. The Ice Elementals took no damage from Crackle. But there's a plenty of damage from Shining Shot. Hey, I'm so glad I got this attack for Angelo. It's gonna help us out greatly in the long run. And I think the Ice Queen's gonna fall to Axes of Evil here. No problem there. And just like that, I got a level up. I told you I was very close. I think it was only like 400 points away. 7 skill points. Now, where do I want to put this? I do want to start building up courage. Kind of gonna go half and half here, because again, I do eventually want to get my sword, because I'll eventually learn Omni Heal, I believe, and likewise I'll learn Giga Slash once I get my sword power all the way to 100 points. Trying to build up both evenly here. Although maybe I should just focus on one, then the other. Do I want to be focused on offense or defense? That's the question. So I do have Angela with multi-heal. And that's been an effective weapon so far, but it doesn't heal fully. Once I learn Omni-heal, I'll be able to heal fully, I believe. Those guys really weren't worth that much experience there. And I see Marta's cottage in the distance. Let's hope she's okay. Hopefully Sir Leopold hasn't caught up to her. Well, so far, nothing out of the ordinary here. Let's see how Marta's doing. Jeez, this place is crawling with hellhounds. Let's just nuke all these guys. Hopefully these guys are all in a group, so should be relatively simple. I wonder if Thwack will work. Let's see what happens. We may have to get a chance to use it, depending on how much damage we do. Didn't work on any of them. Damn. These guys are going at us here. is to burn this lovely decor in this house. But I think, considering the circumstances that we're in, doing damage to the area is not my priority right now. It should be down to the point where we can just take him out with singular shots here. But I gotta be careful, I don't, gotta keep an eye on my HP here, otherwise these guys are actually gonna take me down if I'm not careful. Just down to one. Bunch more of these guys to fight. I might as well fight them all. Actually, that was them all. Okay. Now, where'd Marta go? Just in case I gotta do any more battling here. Downstairs. Jeez, there's even more of them. I had a hunch I had to fight more of you. These guys is all we can do, I think. Should this finish them off? Yep, it does. Didn't even have to use Zap there. But I hope Marta's okay. All these Hellhounds have ravaged her home. Still, Marta's nowhere to be found. There's even more of them in here. Care of those guys. Still, we haven't found Marta, though. Is she anywhere in this house, even? No, she's not in here. Well, everything's cleared out, so let's head outside. She may be hiding in the barn, maybe? No, she's not in here. Maybe she went back here. I don't think I ever went back here. There's a path going back to this cave. Let's see what's behind here. I think I see something. Yeah, surrounded.
Harry, down here.
Sounds like Marta. She's alive. There she is. Some kind of magic barrier. Kind of the one,
They cannot hurt us in here.
Yeah, I'm familiar with this. Master Domenico, he had this spell too.
Evil cannot penetrate the barrier.
So she is a heir to the sages. Yeah, I think they were coming to kill you. Anyway, what's back here? This looks like some kind of ruins. Can't use a map in here, but look. The Gabra Isle is located in a far-flung corner of the world, surrounded by treacherous cliffs so that none may approach. If you wish to reach it without wings, first search for a sea chart to show the way. Follow the light, it'll illuminate your path. I have a feeling this is going to be important to us later on. Let's see what these others have to say. Imperia watches over us from on high. Look to her if evil rears its ugly head again. Well, we could probably use Imperia's help now. The godbird Imperia travels between worlds. She visits these worlds to warn of the threat posed by the Lord of Darkness. I am one of the seven sages. But the Godbird Imperius helped you to seal away the Dark Lord Rapthorn. It is conceivable that many years from now his shadow may rise again to darken the world once more. And so I have carved the story of our friend and ally Imperia here so that future generations may know and understand. Upon hearing her tale, we seven sages pledged to stand and fight alongside her. With Imperia's guidance, we were able to fashion a magical scepter. A scepter with the power to imprison the Dark Lord's evil soul. That became the treasure of Castle Trudaine. So began the battle. In the end, the scepter, empowered by the commingling of our seven bloodlines, were able to entrap Rapthorn. And he's been stuck in that scepter ever since. Yes, we actually did give the herbs to Merrick. Thank you. He's coming here because he's worried about you. Yeah, he is.
What was that noise?
I think we got company here. Glowing red outside.
I have a very bad feeling about this. Something is terribly wrong.
Why don't you guys stay here? We'll check it out. The fact that it's glowing red out, it's not a good sign. Set the damn place ablaze. And there he is, Sir Leopold, in the background with the scepter in his mouth. A bunch of hellhounds. And there's Merrick.
Forgive me. I was coming after you when I was attacked by this dog.
You again. You have a tiresome habit of appearing at the most inopportune moments. But I don't have the time to waste on the likes of you. Heir of the Sage, show your face and accept your fate. Defy me and condemn your own flesh and blood. Defy me, and your son will die!
Mama! Stay inside! If you come out, he will attack! Stay inside!
Marta, what are you doing?
Well, what a surprise! I come out to find the one who taunts me is a dog. But you are not just a dog. I can smell it. I can smell the evil that tells me who you really are.
If you know who I am, You must know what I want. Come quietly, and I promise a quick and painless demise.
Doesn't sound like a good deal to me.
Ha! Release him first, then we will talk.
You are in no position to make demands. Be quiet and come to me.
Well, if you need to take out those hellhounds, I'd be glad to.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You reason like the monstrous beast you are. Very well. I will go to you.
Marta, I hope you know what you're doing. Well, she just gave us the ultimate key. That key will open every door and every chest in the game. So it sounds to me like after this whole ordeal is out of the way, we're going to be going on another big treasure hunt around the world. So I'm probably going to save that for next episode. I'm kind of curious to see how this is going to play out here. We'll get to this later.
Farewell, my friends. Remember, together it is possible to break even an element. Together, you can overcome even the strongest evil.
You choose wisely. In you, the blood of the sages has found a true heir. Such a pity that I must spill it. But there is nothing to fear. Your son will be following you before long.
So that was your plan. But the scythe has hit the stone. You are wrong if you think an old babushka like me has no fire left in her.
You tell him, Marta. What you got there? Was that some kind of pepper bomb there?
Well, you like my nook powder.
Oh yeah, that will definitely sting. Remember what it did to Merrick back in the grotto?
Go, Boris! Hurry!
Pulling Merrick to safety. And down goes Marta. Sacrificing herself for her son. As any good mother would do.
That meddlesome old hag. Trying to cheat me of my destiny. Ah, my eyes! My eyes! Only one seal remains. Just one. When the last heir's blood is spilt, my spirit will finally be free of this scepter.
You better pray you get to him before we take you out permanently. Oh geez, now he's grown wings. A devil dog.
Stop where you are. You aren't getting away this time.
Looks like we have one more battle before this whole thing is over here. So, these guys are easy enough. Let's just go ahead and take them out. Zap. Axes of Evil. Give him a sizzle and a shining shot. That should wipe the whole pack out. Oh, he was going to pay for what he did to Marta there. Hopefully get off our attacks a bit quicker, though. I don't think we really get a single attack on us. Those people are not quick enough. Alright. Let's give them a little rain of pain and blow. The Shining Shot. Took all eight of them out with one flick of the quiver there. Alright. Well, they're out of the way now. You better back off. He's gonna run or fly away. Coward. Kill an old lady, then run. And the Hellhounds are falling back. Unfortunately, we lost Marta.
Mama! No! If only I had not let that dog capture me.
It's not your fault, Merrick. That dog was coming for your mama, whether you liked her or not, no matter where you would have been or done.
I thought I could finally make things up to you. This is all my fault. Mama! That evil dog flew off to the east, yes? East. I think the Lord High Priest's Island is to the east. Oh, yo, you say you have been chasing this dog? You must not give up. We cannot allow another life to be sacrificed like my mother's. You must find him and defeat him.
Well, that's the plan.
Believe me, his list of crimes needed no addition to persuade us of that. But what are we supposed to do now? We finally catch up with the fiend, and he flies off. How can we possibly hope to follow?
Looks like we're going to have to learn how to fly ourselves, I guess.
That is it! Imperia!
Yeah, I was reading about those on the tablets.
If they can fly, then you need to fly too! You must enlist the help of the god bird, Imperia! There are monuments about her in the shrine inside this ruin. It is written on them how she fights against evil. If anyone can help you in this battle, I am certain that Imperia can.
So that's going to be our next destination. We know Leopold is to the east. And we now need to find this goddess Imperia. So any more we can do here. Lord High Priest Silent. We need to look around the ruin and read the instructions. Well, we did that earlier. This told us the tale of Imperia. If you want a quick refresher, I'll go ahead and give it to you. Imperia watches over us from on high. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, we've read this already. But just going to go over it real quick. That scepter that is carrying the soul of the Lord of Darkness, Wraththorn. So we need to find this godbird. Alright, so we now have our next destination in mind.
report was disappointingly inconclusive. We have no idea where the sea chart is, for one thing.
I guess we had to read all those tablets to advance the storyline.
Still, chin up. All we can do now is head east after that pesky hound.
Yep, that's all we can do, so... But actually, before we do that, Marta did give us a key before she passed. The ultimate key opens any treasure or door, so we're going to be going on a worldwide treasure hunt to see if we can find some things that will help us in our endeavors. And before we do even that, we picked up a few more mini-medals. I think it's time we played Princess Mini a visit. So let's go ahead and give these to the princess to see if we get anything out of it. If I recall, I think we were only one away from an item or so. I think we got like 7 or 8 now. I forget exactly how much we have right now. So right now we are at 70 flat. And we got the Miracle Sword for getting 68. So that Miracle Sword basically lets me use Miracle Slash every turn. When I get 75, I get a suit of Sacred Armor. I got a feeling, since I'm probably going to be coming across more mini-belts during my treasure hunts, that's probably going to be getting that very, very soon. So, in the interim, if I equip this Miracle Sword, enchantably, they restore some of your HP every time it strikes an enemy. Does it outrank my Bastard Sword? By a significant margin, 19 points stronger. So it looks like I'll be getting rid of that sword as well. Looks like we also got fully healed after that little endeavor of ours. So we need 5 more mini-medals to get to the next treasure. And since we have that ultimate key, can we get in here now? Yes, we can. Might as well raid these treasures while we're here. Got ourselves a Sea of Life, okay. Gonna give that to Jessica. She's now at 215 hit points. What do we got in here? We got ourselves another main metal, so that's 71 now. And here, a Sea of Strength. I think I'm going to take that one for myself. And lastly, what do we have in here? We unlock it and we get ourselves a double-edged sword. An ill-fated sword surrounded by an air of danger. So, I believe if I equip this, this is actually a cursed item. We will not be able to unequip it. And being that it says double-edged, I got a feeling that it actually damages you when you use it. I'm not 100% sure, and frankly, I don't want to find out. So, you know what? I'm just going to keep it in my inventory and scoot on out of here. Alright, so, just so we have a base to head back to, we're going to head back to Irkutsk, just so we can heal up and save. Maybe do a little work in the equipment management department there. Let's see if there's any new stuff I can get now since I'm going to have a bit of money coming in here. And I've only been recording about a half an hour. I think I'll do some inventory management, then I'll go ahead and end the episode. So, first things first, let's find the inn and take a rest, even though I don't think we're really going to need it, but you never know, you can't be too careful. It cost us 100 gold. We get another cutscene with Medea.
Just that I can't get Marta out of my mind. She's such a lovely old lady.
Yeah, she did a lot for us.
But we should try not to dwell on it. We have so little time together. Let's talk about happier things. That was the first time I've ever seen snow. It was so beautiful. The giant, fluffy white blanket. If we played hide and seek, you'd never be able to find me. I'm so white as a horse.
Yeah, no kidding.
Don't forget to take me to the spring now and then. I miss talking to you.
Yeah, maybe we'll do that during our treasure hunt next episode. I do miss talking to you, although whenever you come to me in my dreams, I mean, it's good to talk every so often. Alright, time to take care of a little financial business and weaponry. Let's skip the item shop. Go through the tavern. I'm not thirsty. I don't drink anymore. Alright. Let's first get rid of some of our old stuff. The Holy Silver Rapier. I'm not going to be using it for Angela, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of it. Jessica's old outfit, no. Still got these old Maury's memos. Can't sell a Templar sword. Or the stockings. Battle fork, don't want to sell. Again, I have a rule, don't sell anything you can't get back. Posh waistcoat, not going to need anymore. I'll get rid of that bandana. I'm going to hold on to the Saint's Ashes, I can use those in alchemy. Dragon gun, can't sell that. Long spear. I think I got that during a random battle. Not gonna use the magic vestment anymore. I guess it's time to get rid of the zombies being as well since I've got the miracle sword now. I was gonna alchemize it, but now I don't think I'm gonna need to. Don't need the edge boomerang anymore either. Steel broadsword. Some of these random enemies that I encounter, they actually do drop weapons. I'm not going to use the ice skill dirk. Bastard sword I'm going to sell. Alright, I'm not going to sell that. Alright, so now we can get some defensive equipment here. Velvet cape I'll get for Angela. Actually, you know what? Let's get a dragon shield for both me and Yangus. I'll have to do some inventory organization there. And the dragon mail. Since I need the boost, I'm going to go ahead and take it for myself for now. Alright, now let's sell the old stuff here. Silver mail. Magic shield. Maybe I can get another one for Yangus. Anything else I can part with? I've got two of these, so I'll go ahead and drop them. Alright. Now I can get the dragon mail for Yangus. I can also get iron headgear, but that's gonna start going into really making me bankrupt at that point, so I'm not gonna bother with that. But I will get rid of this heavy armor. Alright, and I think we're done here. So now, I need to get my inventory to be straightened out here. Put that Elven Elixir back in my inventory. Get some magic water in there. Put the Lesser Panacea in there as well. And I'll carry Bomberman's Bell, just so I have it nearby. I think that's really all I need to worry about. I think everything else I had was, like, herbs and all that. Alright, so, alright, that's gonna do it, I think. Alright. So now, we're heading into the church. Now it's time to call it quits, and like I said, next episode we're going to be doing a little bit of treasure hunting with our new ultimate keys. So until next time, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.